Good morning, friends and viewers, and right. Well, we've been busy doing some work there, but took a look outside the window, and that's what it looks like, guys. So, the sun's nearly up. It's 5 o'clock in the morning. Well, 6 o'clock, I think. And is there any chance the big tuna's there? Well, I'm not too sure, but it's freezing out there. But I think maybe we give it a quick try, you know? This is the time the tuna was there last time, so let's get kitted up. Quickly go out and see if we can trawl. Maybe we get lucky and maybe we catch the tuna. It's gonna be cold. I'm up for it. Right on. Right, so we're outside here now. It is getting brighter. You guys remember our battery charging invention there, right? Yeah. So let's quickly get the batteries off here. We're not going to need the big one, but we're charging two batteries because you use the UPS for the computer, if you remember. And yeah, I am leaving it outside because what happens is these batteries give off a gas, you know, when they're charging. It's not good to keep them inside, guys. So I definitely feel the small one is more than powerful enough. We're not going to be out that long. It's the morning fishing. I mean, look at that. That is just breathtaking. That is just amazing. So, yeah. All right. Let's get our canoe, and we've got our garments and everything else ready. So get the canoe and get ourselves into the water there. Are we gonna get that fish? I don't know. I don't know. That fish, we never. Anyway, it'll be nice to see what's happening down there with. I mean, how busy it's gonna be. You know, it's gonna be a lot of fish down there. Even if we don't catch them, we'll still get a good sonar of what's going on down there. So I kind of think I'm just gonna take the first bucket down there, the beach, and then it looks like it's gonna be a beautiful day. A little choppy, you guys can see, but that means the wind could get worse. I don't think so. Oh yeah, I forgot, I must carry the petrol as well. Okay, so it's good that we do more than one trip. Right, let me get everything down here and I'll get back to you guys in 5. You gotta admit, that breaks my heart every single time I go litter. But because Chris isn't with, can you guys see Roxy through the window there? Shame. But yeah, because Chris isn't with, yeah, I'm not gonna be out long, you know, so. So she's in the house. Chris is there as well, so it's not a problem. She's not alone. But it breaks my heart just watching her like that. Hey, Roxy. Anyway, right, let's go catch this fish. Right, guys, and as always, we've just ran the little boat gently onto the ground, onto the shore here. So yeah, now we just quickly, well, we got these wetsuits on, so it's fine. We just quickly jump out into the sea here and get all the rest of the stuff here. You can't carry that stuff in the canoe, you know. So we've got petrol. There's a bra down there. I don't know how the hell that got there, but anyway. So somebody left their bra there. Yeah, guys, welcome to Greece. Yeah, a lot happens on these beaches. But yeah, so we've got our bucket here, our equipment, basically just the Garmin, the sensor, and the battery. So let's take those as well, and we're ready to get out of here. The rods are in the boat. I leave them in the boat most of the time, so it's kind of cool. Yeah, I get the bucket in there. And of course, now I'm trying to do this with one hand. We've got the sensor here, so we just mount the sensor on the side. Might as well do it while I'm outside the water. Hopefully, don't get the plug wet. guys can see the boat's dragging. Must watch out, don't let the boat go too much sideways, because when it goes too much sideways, the propeller will touch the ground. So we don't want that, you know. Well, it's in neutral now, so it's not actually turning, but you don't want to get that happening to you. Right, so we climb back in and let's go connect everything up and go do some trawling. So right guys, well, we've got both the lines in. But this one here on this side's got a sabiki and the lure. This side here is well, this rod here is just a jig. And right, gear set up, everything's cool. We're still putting some petrol, but we've got too much already in the tank, so we've got no problem there. But I must remember to put it in anyway. Weather is amazing. You guys got to check this out. I mean, that is just amazing. And sunrise, beautiful. We've got a cool fishing boat there as well. They're doing nets and that kind of thing. So they're commercial fishermen kind of thing. Yeah, they're actually working right now. That's the job, to do the commercial part. But on our side, we're gonna go down to there, somewhere down there. That's where we saw the big tuna, this elusive tuna that we keep on going for. So yeah, we're gonna go down there, trawl a bit of that, and then hopefully just trawl up and down the coastline a little bit close to home. We're not gonna go far today. Kind of feel the way the weather looks now, it's just gonna get more windy and more jittery like it's been every day last week. So yeah, I'm not gonna go out and into the deep and everything else, and it's freezing. But I'm gonna keep you guys informed. Let's get to that spot, slowly putting there, and yeah, let's see if we catch anything or even get a bite. You know what, even if we see it on the sonar, that would still be kind of cool. But let's see what we see. Right on. Guys, I don't know if you can see that, but that is a cool school of fish down there. As you can see, it's a whole shit load of fish. So, now if we're going for sabiki, it'd be easy to, just throw the sabiki lines in there. We're not actually trawling, so what we're going to do is we're going to trawl over it, and then I'm going to come back and trawl through it again a couple of times. Because there's another school coming up just now. What happens is the big fish are also swimming through those kind of things, you know. So that's like all bait fish. But yeah, there was a lot down there. We're going to turn around just now, waiting for the lure lines to go through there. It's quite deep. I don't know if our lures are that deep. But yeah, we're going to turn around and go straight back through that again. And yeah, there's a lot of fish out here in the morning. That is a good sign. Maybe we should prep with Chris and come out with the sabikis and do some sabiki fishing. I'm pretty sure we're going to catch quite a few like that in the mornings, a lot more than in the evenings actually, which is kind of cool. All right, well, we're going to carry on trotting. We're going to turn around, and if something interesting happens, I'll show you guys again. So right guys, I was trying to do some trawling for that the fish we'd seen on that on the Garmin. The problem is that a bunch of fishermen on the shoreline there got upset with me because they think I'm chasing away the fish. But you can see there's a lot of activity down here, so you know, they were saying yeah you're chasing away the fish. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to carry on putting down the coastline. It's not that bad. It's cold, but it's not that bad. So the whole idea today is basically to go around that little edge that you see down there. And there's another cool part down there, another little bay where, you know, you never know. I think I've caught a lot with paragadi there. I've never trawled there actually, so I'm going to go slowly through there as well. And up to the ancient harbour. Maybe I can show you guys the ancient harbour as well. And then of course, we'll see how that goes. Right. So we're carrying on forward that way. Interesting fact. If you can see it on top of the mountain there, there's a cool ancient windmill. You should be getting it in the frame there. If you go on Google Earth, you'll see it on Google Earth in 3D as well. I made that model when I was learning how to use SketchUp. just for fun, you know, I wanted to see how SketchUp compares to 3D Max or to Maya and Cinema 4D, and well, it's a different way of designing and everything else, but yeah, we put up a couple of models on Google Earth. There was, you know, I think Google Earth stopped that now, so I don't think you can put models up there anymore. And there was no pay in it, so it was just a lot of work and just basically doing it for fun, like a hobby, you know. But that was one of the models we did put up on there. So yeah, it's a beautiful little windmill. One day we might even walk up there and check it out. Sea's looking okay. I'm looking forward to going right in front here, where we're going to get a bit more of a very, very calm sea there, because it's shielded by the mountain here. But yeah, that was a very, very nice little model. As for the fish, well, yeah, you guys know the fish, yeah. We still haven't caught one, but who needs to catch fish in such a beautiful sea, right? It's just so beautiful again. So yeah, we've got a bit more time before we've got to get back in and start working. So yeah, let's continue. We'll keep you guys in touch. Yep, sometimes the weather just fixes up and yeah, that just becomes amazing. You see now I'm sitting in front of the boat. I've moved all the way to the front of the boat here, chilling in the front here. We're trawling the lines. Still no bites, but you gotta check the sea out. I mean, you gotta check the sea out here. That is just amazing. So yeah, we're definitely gonna put back a little bit around this, check it out a bit, and yeah, it's starting to get warmer. The sun is coming out, so it's going to get a little warmer, and yeah, we're just going to putt around here a bit before we have to get out and go do some work. But for now, you gotta see me. Come on, you know, that's gotta be. Beautiful. And you know, the whole of summer looks like this most of the time. So yeah, amazing. Maybe we still catch, I mean, we're still trying to catch the fish, right? Yeah. Well guys, with weather like this, yeah, we decided to go deep. You guys can see the shoreline is far away that side, and we're still trawling the lines, but it's just looking majestic. Now, there's an underwater island somewhere here, about 2 kilometers in front of us. We want to go around that a few times, you know, maybe we get lucky around that little island there. Yeah, I'll show you guys the nav chart, you check it out. And, well, hopefully we can get around there. I'm also dying to see what it looks like on the Garmin when we get to that island, you know what I mean? Like, how does it go up, and will there be a lot of marine life around there? Yeah, that'll be kind of cool as well. There is some ships there. There's one fishing boat right back there. There's another one straight in front. And by the island, the stuff you've seen down there, right in front, is fish farms. Those are fish farms. So yeah, if we go close to them, we're going to have to, of course, pull up our lines, because yeah, we don't want to catch the fish farms. But anyway, we're going to go try to circumnavigate that underwater island first, if we can find it. And yeah, excited to see what it looks like across the Garmin. And as I said, yeah, let's see if there's any fish down there. Right guys, we've got to the island, well, the underwater island. It's definitely there. I don't know if you can see it, but on the Garmin, we're at 66 meters right now. We're still in the depth. In a deep blue, we're approaching that island there, but it's still quite far away. Somebody's already put some kind of net here. They're kind of fishing the spot. And yeah, it's definitely, it goes from about 120 meters all the way to 60 meters, which is yeah, kind of cool. It's even going less now, 62 meters, 61 meters. And it shocks me that, well, even this spot is somebody who's put the nets inside. Yeah, it's getting even less now, 57 meters. Man, that's quite impressive. So, yep, on the sonar chart it's there. And it's definitely here in RL. no appreciate on my side, but yeah, at least I got very close to somebody's basket there. Yeah, there's some serious activity down there now. If you take a look at that, there's some serious activity. Could be his net as well, so I'm not too sure. That could even be his net. Seems to be a very steep ledge here as well. Wow, actually it's getting a lot more shallow. The ledge is oh wow, that's an insane amount of fish. Wow. There's a lot of stuff happening here. Holy macaroni. Yeah, it's like there's a lot of stuff happening here. Man, I'm gonna stick around a bit, but I'm gonna go a few times around. Gonna kill the speed as well. I mean, there's quite a bit of activity down there. Yeah, let me troll around here for a few minutes and see what happens. It might be some fun. And the big fish will come to equal the small fish, right? In theory. I mean, if you look here, look at the amount of fish down here. There that is. That's a lot of fish. Wow. Okay, there's some serious fish here. Oh, fish bait. If we had a cast net, that'd be quite brilliant. But we don't, I don't think they're legal in this anyway. So yeah, we're gonna plot around here just for a few minutes. Check it out. Looks like we might be getting a bit of wind coming and a bit of waves coming just now, so we might have to run back to shore. But we're very far from shore as it is, so yeah, in all, we've got 35 meters on this little island, which is very impressive. Very, very, very impressive. Alright, I'll let you guys know what happens. Here's another cool view. We see a lot of this in Greece. The fire planes are busy rehearsing or practicing. As you guys can see them there, they're coming in, and I hope I'm not in their way. I don't think I am. But yeah, they're doing some training and that, because yeah, there's a lot of fire here on summer, so yeah, there they go. And they might even land, I'm not sure. Maybe they're just going to fly past, I'm not sure. They looks like they're going to land. There's no wind, so you can't go downwind. I suppose you just land any direction you want. Remember guys, in flying, always back off into wind and land into wind. Wind must be coming from in front of you. Always, always, always. Okay, in case you're flying. That's why we've got those socks. Look at those socks. Wind in front of you. But yeah, they seem to be, I don't know where they're going. Let's see the map there. And right now you can see the distilleries outside. Well, the refinery. Here's a fish farm right here. These are the fish farms. They're like around this island, and they put them into the water here, and they breed the fish inside there, which is quite cool. There's a lot of fish in there, and that's a list of the if you look straight down there, there's the Corinth Channel again, straight in front of us. You can see it, and those planes seems like they might be landing. Not to sure yet. I don't know if they were doing a fly around or whatever, you know, to take a visual and then try. It looks like they're just flying right by. Maybe they land. But for now, they might be just leaving. Sea looks brilliant again. A lot closer to the fish farm now, so I'll stand up and show you guys. I'm not going to go too close to it because I'm falling in the lines, but yeah, you guys can see there's nets around there and everything else. And this island here is a scary island. It's called Snake Island, and you don't want to walk on that island there. It seems like there's a lot of snakes in it, if not mistaken. Ah, well, seeing we came all the way out here, I mean, might as well show you, go closer to the Snake Island and the, what you call it, the fish farms. So, this is what the fish farms look like. You can see they've got like little trucks there that, well, little barges that, like, feed the fish. There they're busy feeding the fish as well. There's another, it's like these rings with nets around them. And yeah, so these guys are feeding the fish. There's a lot of fish activity here, but the fish don't actually bite on bait apparently, because they constantly, you know, they just come and eat the remainder food from these fish farms. So there's a lot of activity here, I believe. You can see on the fish finder down there, seems like it is very active. And yeah, we're gonna go around Snake Island. There's something in the water there which I'm scared of because I'm trawling my lines. Oh wow, and there you can see the planes, they're busy. I don't know if you can catch that in the camera, they just threw the water down. So they're picking up water from somewhere. Maybe deep down, they're doing deep down inside there, the exercises. I'm gonna try turning a little bit here just to get away from whatever this is. And then, yeah, I don't know what that is. Looks like a bottle or something. And then we got closer to the fish farm that side, and you can actually smell the fish food here. It's kind of yeah, it's kind of cool. You can smell it. So you can see the gents are working. There's a lot of birds on these cages. My goodness gracious me. Okay, so I mean, seeing we've come all the way out here, we'll go around Fish Island as well, or Snake Island, and see what happens there. As we ride by the Snake Island, guys, this is what the island looks like. Yeah, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. You got a lot of seagulls flying around here as well. So the seagulls are having a lot of fun around here as well. As for, there was a lot of readings as well there. Yeah. There was a lot of readings on the fish finder as well. So there's a lot of fish activity. Yeah, it's insane. I suppose they were drawn by the fish farm. And especially around the fish farms, there's just so many of them, you know. And right, there's some smoke on top of the mountain there, so I don't actually know if planes are gonna go try to throw water on that, because there is smoke up there. Maybe it's part of the exercise, and those guys are gonna go and dump water on it just now, I think. Maybe, no, but yeah, Snake Island. So if you do get stranded, well, the seagulls are having a lot of fun, and it is beautiful, but kind of scared of it because of the snakes, right? Quite far from home, but the weather is just still so beautiful. There's some choppiness coming, you can see over there. But yeah, that still looks fine. I mean, there's not much wind. Sun is getting warmer, so a lot more comfortable. I nearly fell over, so I've got to watch my step. Yeah, very, very nice. Guys, well, we've decided to start heading back home. It's still beautiful. The weather's very, very nice. There's a bit of a breeze, but nothing wrong. We didn't catch any fish again, but we did find some cool places where there are fish, which is kind of nice. And definitely we're going to take them to be here. But for now, it's just going to take a short boat. Yeah, it's getting a little windy, but nothing to worry about, just a little chilly. Yeah, summer's on its way, man. How are you? Right on. So, yeah, that was for today's trip. At least we saw the island, we saw Snake Island. Still didn't catch a fish. And we'll catch one, right? Well, guys, yeah, we caught something. Yeah, a plastic bag. Well, we're still on the way home, but we're still trawling our lines. The weather's just remarkable, man. But yeah, okay, let me get this thing off the hook and throw our lure back in. Yeah, right. And well, guys, we're back home now. And there's Roxy. And, well, okay. All we caught was a plastic bag, but it was another cool adventure. Right on. See you guys in the next one.